Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dean Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.1, Problem 11. This is Section 3.1, Problem 11. It says, graph the feasible region for the system of linear inequalities and determine if it is bounded or unbounded. And we have 2x plus 4y is greater than or equal to 8, x is greater than or equal to 0, and y is greater than or equal to 0. These last two with a greater than or equal to 0 are very common when you have a system of linear inequalities. They're almost always in a system. When you have more than one, these are going to be included most of the time. And what they do, as you'll see, they just trap you into this upper right quadrant of your Cartesian coordinate system of your graph. So let's start with 2x plus 4y is greater than or equal to 8. So let me make a little chart for that and pretend that it's 2x plus 4y equals 8. Ignore the inequality just for this first step of the four-step process to graph this. So first, let me let x equal 0 and see what y value I would need to make the equation I'm pretending that I have true. So if x is 0, the 2 times x becomes 2 times 0, and I'm left to solve the equation 4y equals 8. Well, y must be 2. 4 times 2 would make 8 equals 8. So if x is 0, y is 2, there's a point with coordinates that would make the inequality true if I pretend that it's an equation. And for a second point, I'm going to now let y equal 0 and see what x would have to be. So if y is 0, the 4 times y becomes 4 times 0, and it drops out of the equation that I pretend I have, and I have 2x equals 8. Again, I'm pretending that it's an equals. X would have to be 4. 2 times 4 would make 8 equals 8. So 4 for x and 0 for y is another point with coordinates that makes the inequality true if I pretend it's an equation. So let me start graphing these two points. So step one is find the two points. Step two is plot those two points on a graph. So one of them is 0, 2. So over 0 up 2 would be right here, over 0 up 2. And the second point, 4, 0, x is 4, y is 0. So over 4 up 0 would be there. So that's step two, plot the two points on a graph. Step three, connect them with a straight line. I'm going to use a solid line because I have the or equal to in my inequality symbol. If I didn't, I'd use a dashed line. So I'm going to take my ruler, and I'm going to line up the two points, and I will connect them. Solid line. Now, the last step, step four, I have to decide if I shade underneath or up above. Which half of the graph do you shade? So to determine that, choose a test point that's not on the line. Use 0, 0 if you can. And 0, 0 is not on the line, so I get to use my favorite test point. Plug it into the linear inequality you're trying to graph, 0 for x, 0 for y, and see if the result is true or false. So if I 0 the x and 0 the y, I have the statement 0 is greater than 8. Well, that's not true. 0 is not greater than 8. So my test point was on the underneath side. The result it gave me is false. So the other side must be shaded. So this is the blank side, the side my test point came from. The other side, the up above side, is the shaded side. Like that. So that's the first linear inequality. Now these two go very easily. X is greater than or equal to 0 means I want the points only with positive x coordinates. So x coordinates of, you know, 3, 5, 7, 8, none of the negatives. So from the y-axis to the right is that x greater than or equal to 0. So it's here. And now the y greater than or equal to 0, basically you want everything above the y, above the x-axis, anything with a positive y coordinate. So it's going to be all this stuff here. So the feasible region winds up being everything to the upper right except for this little corner in the bottom. So you can go out further and further and further with no limit. So the last part of the question, is your feasible region bounded or unbounded? It's unbounded because it goes forever. To be bounded, it has to be completely enclosed, finite area, which is not the case. This is unbounded. It goes forever.